sorry. I thought that all of you can see my screen. So my point was 5 to 6 years if you do it parallel to your med school, else you'll spend 1 year for step one and one extra year for CK, CS clinical rotations, okay, in the internship. All right. Once you have everything, every year the application starts in the month of September. Once you have made the application, you have to go for in-person interview. I told you USMLE is the job. So you go for interviews. Okay. So somebody asked me, what about a visa? So this particular slide will give you what all visas are you requiring. So initially, everybody requires a normal B1, B2 tourist visa, which somebody who is in first or second year of medical school can just approach a travel agent and get this visa. Once you have this visa, this is a 10-year visa in which you can give the CS practical exam, do the clinical rotation, and go for these interviews also. Okay, normal tourist visa is required. Now, once you have given your interviews in the month of February, okay, you have to actually let them know. For example, if you have applied to 100 hospitals, and let's say you've got 10 interviews, so you have to inform the body called as NRMP. This body is the counseling body that I want. First is New York Hospital, second is Arizona Hospital, third is California, fourth is Arizona, so whatever you like. Okay, so this preference you have to submit. Similarly, when universities interview 100, 200 students, so they also submit their own list. In India, we call it merit list. In America, they call it rank list. So universities also will submit their list. Okay, and you will submit your choice. And the results are announced in the month of March, which is called as matching. It's an online algorithm. So if you like a program and a program likes you, that's when you match. And July onwards, your PG starts in America. Now, once your PG starts, you are on a work visa, which is your H-1B and J-1 visa. That's when you are on work visa. So there is no student visa in the American process. And it is for every student, okay? After graduation, America process takes one extra year. I told you in advance, people require patience, but if you have patience, your life is going to set forever. Now, okay, the process looks a little complicated, okay? Now, process looks a little complicated, but why do you think thousands of Indian students prepare for USMLE? Why people are doing that? One biggest example is this COVID pandemic. If I was an engineering student, and when the pandemic started in the month of March, and when I was looking for the visa date, there was no date available before January or February of 2021. I'm talking about in the month of March and April. Okay. And can you see this? This year also people got admission in March. So they had to join their university in July. Am I correct? So what do you think? Were people able to join or not? Because in the process, a visa was required. So they had to go to the MCI. They had to go to the visa office. Do you think people made it this year? Absolutely yes. Special fast track visas were done for students. Special Vande Bharat flights were flown in the month of June. People actually, the first week of June, lots of flights went to America. People completed their mandatory quarantine period. And July 1st onwards, their PG started. So even in the period of pandemic, the visas were processed smoothly. What does that show? This shows the dependence of American system of Indian students. There is a huge demand of Indian students. This is something all of us need to understand. American help, COVID has actually exposed the shortage, not only in America, even in India. We all have realized that our priorities were something very weird. Our priority had to be healthcare, but I don't know what, we're busy, you know, building monuments. But now this is something very serious. All the countries have realized, including America. And second obvious reason for America is this simple mathematical graph. Those who can understand this graph will realize why America is so much dependent on Indian students. The orange graph is the number of PG seats in America. The yellow graph is the number of MBBS seats in America. So they have more PG seat, less MBBS seat. And which is why the green graph is the vacant seat available for green card holders, for the people who want visa, everyone. So they have surplus of seats. Okay. Now, what is the problem with India? Do you want to understand? India, the PG seats are correct. They are also 30,000. Indian PG seats are 30,000. But what is the MBBS seat ratio in India? Around close to 70,000. Plus people who write the NEET exam last year, who could not get admission, those 40,000 students appear. Plus people who tried NEET examination last to last year and could not get admission, they appear. Plus there are eternal optimists. Last 3 years they have been writing NEET, they appear. So every year 1.5 lakh students appear the NEET PG. And if you consider the government seats, out of 1.5 lakhs, only 15,000 seats are there. So for every 10 student in India, one gets a seat, or else they have to be ready with 1 crore rupees. I hope you guys are able to understand the simple math. Okay, somebody was asking, what after PG, what are the salaries? This is the salary. Even if you are just in medicine, pediatrician, infectious, neurologist, you are earning 1.5 to 2 crore rupees. If you do psych, patho, nephro, almost 2.5 crores. The top ones are plastic surgery, orthopedics, cardio, gastro, radio. And even here, there are lots of Indian students. Okay, so it's not that it's not available. Except for dermat, there is no problem.